And the days that I keep my gratitude higher than my expectations, well, I have really good days.
Good morning, everybody. How are you doing today? Wonderful, I hope. Doing absolutely wonderful here. It went straight from summer to winter with about 3 days of fall. So I guess we'll see what happens here, but I love this kind of weather, minus the rain and the mist and all that stuff. Before I get started, I want to do a shout out to Crypto Kenzie, Crypto and Culture. We did a live stream last night and had some technical difficulties and oh my gosh, what a refreshing evening just to be able to talk to somebody with that much passion and that much energy. And I really enjoyed it. And brother, I hope we get a chance to do it again, because an hour and a half went by and I didn't even really get to ask you some of the things that I wanted to ask you and talk about. But I just really appreciate it. That was my first stream. And I got some kinks to work out, like, you know, his audio on my video wasn't that good. And on his, it had us side by side. And on my screen, it had me in a little bitty picture. And so I got some technical stuff to work out. But all in all, it was such a good time. Absolutely love that song that I start off my videos with since I got back. It's a song by Ray Wiley Hubbard called Mother Blues, and I love songs with great lyrics, and that song is really unusual. So if you ever get the chance, go look up Ray Wiley Hubbard, Mother Blues, and listen to that whole song. It's great. And that song came back across my radar the day before we left to go on the road trip. And the message in that song is the last line of that song, and it has become my mantra about keeping your gratitude higher than your expectations. And I think that is such an awesome mindset to have. And it all happens right between your own ears. Ain't nobody in charge of that but you. So if that's something that you want to do, well, then you hold the keys to that car. I got one thing I want to do a follow-up with on the stream. And I'm going to hit this one story here real quick, because for people that don't understand why crypto is needed, take a look at this story right here. They just sent over $1 billion. They did it in two transactions. Over $1 billion and paid about $3 in fees. My goodness gracious. Can you even do a $20 withdrawal at the airport ATM for less than $3? Nah, you can't. You can't. That's just, it's just stupid. And that's why this is going to be something that is more broadly accepted in the future, because it's just, people are getting feed to death. All right, so at the very ass end of our live stream last night, we were talking about a couple of small picks and a lottery ticket. And this was the lottery ticket that I mentioned. Now, first of all, let me show you why I like it. I'll show you why I don't like it. And I'm going to show you why I went ahead and did it. All right. So here's the coin. Here it is. It's Rebis. It's not on CoinGecko. It's not on, it's on Twitter, and they had a pre-sale on Sunday. Now, I did this one as a lottery ticket, and if this is something you want to do, do not put very much money in it. This is a lottery ticket. Maybe not the dollar scratch-off. Maybe it's one of the $25 scratch-offs, but it is absolutely a lottery ticket pick for me. All right, so here's the deal. They had a pre-sale on Sunday. I don't think they sold that much, but I do know that the price went over $300, $400. And boy, do I feel sorry for some of the guys that might have got hit up with that. However, there's not much liquidity in the pool. There's not much volume, so a buy or a sell either direction has a pretty dramatic effect on that price. Now, it says that it's a DeFi project. How is it a DeFi project? I don't know. I absolutely do not know. And if you go to their website, you will see that it is a web page. There's a lot of things you can do on this web page. I guess you can change languages to either French or Russian. You can connect your wallet, or you can earn the token. And what's the purpose of this project? I got no idea. I got no idea whatsoever. So why did I put any money into it? Again, I'm not even looking at the cards. I'm looking at the players. And in this game, that old expression about I don't have to outrun the bear, I only have to outrun you, it kind of speaks volumes about this. Sometimes there's an old expression that says when somebody tells you who they are, believe them. Believe them. And since we're close to Halloween, I guess this is a good example as any, and I've used this before, but I know we got a lot of new viewers here. And as we approach Halloween, I've always found this to be a very appropriate example. It's like when you go to a Halloween party and the sluttiest girl you know, bless her heart, we love her to death, but deep down, the sluttiest girl that you know, what is her Halloween costume of choice? Oh, the slutty nurse. Yeah, that's a real stretch of the imagination there. I'd have never caught that. What's your costume again? Oh, slutty nurse. Okay. Man, this is kind of hot though, huh? Man. And penmanship is important. So that's important. But yeah, not a real big stretch to imagine you as a slutty nurse. Now I'm going to ask you kindly not to think any evil thoughts of this woman right here, because I think I love her. Man, look at those eyes.
What'd you say?
Love you.
I love you. I don't know if I love you, but you sound like somebody I could love. Drunk and horny. And I love that.
When really this could have done just the exact same job as a Halloween costume. Here. not much of a stretch of the imagination there, right? So they're telling us, when you look at all the work that's gone into this web page, I was going to say website, but when you go into it, and the only couple of things that you can do is to connect your wallet and to earn tokens. And what does it happen when we click here? Oh, it sends us to Dex Tools. The only reason that I did this one is that I am banking on people's reaction to it, not the play itself. There's only 768 tokens. That's it, which I really, really like. I see here other exchanges and everything. I don't know how much faith I put into that. What they do is one Rebis token per 2 hours for the first 24 hours. So 12 Rebis tokens. They airdrop to the new liquidity providers to split. Now, it's only the new liquidity providers, and it doesn't count the rest of the ones that are in there. Basically, I ended up getting a third of the airdrop, which I cashed out, and it's already paid for. So what I'm going to do, now that I've already done that, you can only get it one time, is I guess I'm going to go and take those out of the liquidity pool, transfer them over to another wallet, and do it again on my other wallet, and let this thing give me a little extra pocket change. And again, this is something I didn't even throw that much money at. I threw like a half an ETH at it, okay? And not that many people are adding liquidity for some reason. I mean, here's all the ads that there are since Sunday. That's it. And two of those are me. And I'm like, okay, well, hey, 12 Rebis. And they're, what, $60 a piece right now? It's $720 to be split by the liquidity providers. Okay, I'll get back my initial investment and see where this thing goes. Well, I got my first airdrop yesterday. With about a half an ETH investment, I ended up getting about a third of the entire airdrop. So I took that, sold that. I'm already even. Now, and it doesn't look like that many people are still providing liquidity. Now, how long will this go on? It'll go on until it doesn't. Is this the next Bitcoin? No. Is it the next rug pull? Maybe. Maybe. Like I said, when somebody tells you who they are, believe them. And we got a website that basically tells us a mission statement, and then a way to buy it. And that's it. That's all we really know, how to buy it. So, hey, you know what? I already got my money out in about 12 hours, and if these kind of airdrops keep up for a while, and the majority of this liquidity pool is the team itself, and they're not taking any of it, I'm going to see where this one goes. Now, if you go over to Crypto Culture's page, you're going to see this video right here called Do This Now. Now, I'm going to put a link to this in the description below. I want you to watch this and do exactly what the title video says to do. Do this now. You go in and you revoke access to applications in the past that you've given permission to your wallet. Now, I went in and did this immediately with this project after I interacted with it, because, and if you watch this video, you'll see exactly what the deal is. Once you have given them permission to have access to your wallet, they can come in and clean out your wallet. Not just that coin, but once they're in the door, they have access to the whole thing. So, I went and did that immediately because, again, I don't know exactly what this project is. I know what it ain't, and I don't feel like leaving the keys in the car with the engine running, if that makes any sense whatsoever.
Let's hide in the attic.
No, in the basement. Why can't we just get in the running car?
Are you crazy?
So if this is something that you decided you wanted to do, make sure that you do this, but definitely come over and watch this video. And if you've been interacting with MetaMask or Uniswap, you want to do exactly what he shows you how to do in this video. All right, that's pretty much it, guys. Y'all take care. Have a wonderful day. Sunshine, lollipops, rainbows, unicorns, and all that good stuff. And we will talk to you next time. Vaya con huevos.
Why you won't be like that right there? Just to bring me some of those teasers.